Hello friends, I'm Akash Raut and welcome to Akash Biology. In this video tutorial, we will be mainly reading about the Michaelis Menten constant. It is one of the most important constant that is being used in enzymology. We all know only a little about of this but do not know the in-depth concept and how the equations is being derived in order to know the Michaelis Menten constant. So in this video tutorial, we will mainly reading about the enzymology. So in-depth mechanism of enzymology. So as we all know, what is an enzyme? Enzyme is a biological catalyst that is being produced by the living cell, which alters the rate of reactions that occurs inside our body. So in order to know about what actually is enzyme, we can just relate a teacher-student relationship. So teacher acts as what? A catalyst in the student life of the students. There are books that a student can read, but only the just a companionship or the guidance of the teacher can enhance the knowledge. What enhance the only the knowledge of the students. So the teacher acts as a catalyst in the student life. That's we can know. And the enzyme acts on what? Substrate. What? Enzyme acts on substrate. So for any chemical reaction to take place, like as in chemistry, reactions and products, so reactants react with each other with what? Along with what? Enzymes. To form a product. So let's say a reactions. So enzyme reacts with what? Substrate. And this is what? Rate constant. Then it will form what? Enzyme substrate complex. Then after that it will form what? Enzyme plus product. Enzyme plus product. So let's say this is K2. And in any chemical reaction at the equilibrium, what they all are what? Reversible in form. So it is K minus 1. This reaction is also reversible, that is K minus 2. So what? Enzyme reacts with substrate to form enzyme substrate complex. Then after that, enzymes plus product. Then Michaelis what think of his period that during the initial phase of reaction, the product is so much less that it will not what again form the enzyme substrate complex. This means what? First of all, enzyme substrate will form enzyme substrate complex, then this can also be dissociated into form enzyme and substrate. Again, this can form E plus P, and E plus P can again form E and S. But during the initial phase of reactions, the product, the concentration of product is so much less that this reaction is not possible to be reversed. So K minus 2 during the initial phase of reaction do not exist. What? Do not exist during only the initial phase of reaction. During initial phase, K minus 2 do not exist. That we have to remind. Now, coming on to this. At any point of T that we can know in chemistry, the rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reactions. So let us consider these equations. So at any time t, for example t, the rate of formation of ES is rate of dissociation of ES. So what is the rate of formation of ES? All we can say, this is the what? K1. We have to take the reactants. Now rate of dissociation means K minus 1 ES. So means E. Is a simple mathematics, that is K minus 1 by K, and this is known as what? Dissociation constant. What? Dissociation constant of ES. It is often denoted by KS. So what is dissociation constant means? The concentration of reactant by concentration of the product for these reactions. So this is the dissociation constant, which is denoted by what? Ks. Now coming on to another thing, we have to remember just this thing. Now can I rub it? Yes. Now coming into, at any time the total concentration of enzymes, let's say this is a total enzymes, so enzyme may be present in two form, either in the free form or in the or the connection with the substrate. So let's say this is a molecule of the holo enzyme, is full enzymes, so it may exist as a free in the reactions or it may be combined with the substrate. So the total enzyme means E plus ES. I think it may be clear to you. Now what was the dissociation constant KS equals to? E S by ES. Now we can equate the value of E. So what is the value of E? That is KS ES. That is equals to, and E means over here, E is equals to E. And now we will equate the value of E in these equations. That is E naught minus ES over ES. Now is a simple mathematic equations. That is E naught is equals to KS. Now what we will do, I will rub this because it is quite hard for me to accommodate all the space over here. Then or from this KS is equals to total enzyme substrate. Now this is a simple mathematic equation that all we can derive. So we will what take common as, so what remains, KS plus S is equals to plus this. Now I will rub this. Now what is the equations? That is enzyme substrate is equals to I think this is clarifiable to you. Now this is the what, the amount of that you can copy in your text, that ES is equals to total enzyme plus substrate by dissociation constant plus substrate. This is the equations. Now let's say again, now coming on to the final reactions. What was our reactions? E plus S goes to ES, then E plus P. Now let's say our reactions proceeded to the product. What? Product. So what is the rate of formation of product? Rate of formation of E plus P, let's say, then it will be K to ES. Simple, because from the same the chemistry reactions. And rate of formation of EP means the velocity. What? The velocity of the reactions, the velocity of formations of product. So the velocity means what? K2 and ES. Now we will equate the value of ES in this equation, then what the velocity will become? The K2 then it will become KS plus S. This is the anytime the velocity of the reactions. Now we have to think of one thing. I will rub this. I think this is clarifiable to you. Then we have to know about another things. what is the maximum velocity of any reactions. So let's say this is enzyme, this is substrate. So which one of the following is the limiting factor for reactions? Obviously this enzyme, because with respect to the substrate, enzyme is always present in a smaller amount. The thing which is smaller amount is always be the limiting factor. So let's say there are 5 molecules of enzyme, this is 20 molecules over here. If the 5 molecules of enzymes are consumed, so even the substrate is being present here, the reaction will not proceed. What? The reaction will not proceed. So the maximum velocity of the reactions will be what? The instant in which whole of the enzyme will be consumed. So what was our reactions? E plus S, forming ES, then it will form E plus P. Here was K2. So our rate of reaction, so the maximum velocity will be means K2, and in the part of ES will be write what? E0. That is the total concentration of enzyme. So the maximum velocity is the point at which whole of the enzyme is being consumed, even in the form of free form or in combination with the substrate. Then what we will write? Oh, sorry, it was E into S. I forgot the reactions. Let me check. It was like this. So K2 into E0 means what? Vmax into S. It was Ks plus S. So what we can write? V0 is equals to Vmax S Ks plus S. So this reaction is of the Michaelis Menten constant. What's Michaelis Menten constant? So what does the Michaelis Menten constant will signify? It will signify the velocity of any reactions at any instant. Now it has got some modifications. So which scientists give modification? Briggs and Haldane gives some modification to the Michaelis Menten constant. What was the modifications? I will drop this. So what was our reactions? E plus S. So what does the Michaelis-Menten constant form? So as we form the ES, then ES has got two fields. Either it will come in this direction or it will go in the E plus P direction. But what does the Michaelis-Menten only consider? It will consider the backward into the ES. But Briggs and Haldane what comment? That the ES either go in the backward direction or either in the forward directions. So first of all, the rate of formation of ES. So what was the rate of formation of ES? Means K1. Now what is the dissociations? So it will go either in the this form, that is K1, K minus 1, ES, or it will go in these directions. So it will go in this direction means K2 ES. Now how we will rearrange this? We will rearrange it like this. So ES. Just a minute, I have to ES then ES. Oh, K1. So we will take common as, so simply we will take ES as common, then what will remain? K minus 1 plus K2, that is ES is equals to K1 K1 E plus S by K minus 1 plus K2, or therefore ES by E plus S is equals to K1 K minus 1 plus K2, and this is known as what? Michaelis Menten constant. So the real value of the Michaelis Menten constant, what given by what? Which scientist? Briggs and Haldane. What? Briggs and Haldane. So what is that Km? Km means again as this previous, what's ES by E plus S. And if we know the rate of reaction in the chemistry, means various rates of reaction, then we can calculate what? The Michaelis Menten constant. So this is the rate of forward reaction K1, rate of backward reaction plus K2 rate of again forward reactions. So in any examinations, if we have given the rate of forward reaction of the enzyme substrate product, if we have given again this value and this value, now it then we got a question that how do you calculate the Michaelis Menten constant. So simply is the formula K1 by K minus 1 plus K2, and we can easily calculate. So this is the concept behind it. Now again we'll again clarify this. So this is Km. I will again rub this. So Km means ES by S. Now I'm getting confused because just woke up from an afternoon nap. So this equation like this, I have just made it reciprocal by ES. The reaction was like this. So from just by replay it, then you can just solve over here. Now this reaction means the enzyme means over here means the total concentration of enzyme means what? Total concentration of enzyme minus enzyme substrate complex plus S by ES. So from over here what we can know that, so Km means E naught into S minus ES into S by enzyme substrate complex. Again same mathematics applied. Now I will rub this again. My board is so small that sorry for this. Plus ES into S. Then again. Now we will take common OH, ES common, then what we will get? Km plus S. That is E naught S. Like this. Now I will rub this again. So Km plus S will become E naught S by ES. And in this reaction, and we again know, so Km plus S will come like this. So Km means Michaelis Menten constant, right? Michaelis Menten constant. And we have got the velocity as K2ES from these reactions like this. So we will just compute the value of V naught K2ES. Now the ES will come like this. So this is the reaction. So the V naught at any time means K2 E naught S Km plus S, and K2 E means Vmax. What? Vmax at S plus S. So what does the Briggs and Haldane do? They have just made the dissociation constant into Michaelis Menten constant. And how it is done, we can see the various processes. Now let us assume at any time the velocity of the reaction is equal to half of the maximum velocity. This is the velocity at any time t, So at any time, this velocity at a moment is half of the maximum velocity. So when V naught equals to V max by 2, then what are the equations will become? That is V max by 2 or V max S by Km plus S. So this will, or simple mathematics. So Km, so what is Km? So we can see the what actually is Michaelis Menten constant. It is the substrate. What? It is the amount of substrate at which what the velocity of the reaction is half of the maximum velocity. So if we put it in graph, so let's say this is velocity, this is the substrate, and this is what maximum velocity, Vmax. So the reaction goes like this. So this is what the maximum velocity is it. This is what V50 means Vmax by 2. So the amount of substrate at which the velocity of reaction is half of the maximum velocity is what? Km, Michaelis Menten constant. It is expressed in millimoles per liter. Millimoles per liter. So less the value of, so what? The less the value of Km means, so whenever the substrate leans means, so at less level of substrate, maximum velocity is achieved. So less Km means there's more strong affinity between the substrate and the enzymes. Where the when there is more Km means more amount of substrate it will be consumed to gain the same half of the maximum velocity. So more Km means less affinity. Less Km means more affinity. So this video is all about the Michaelis Menten constant. I have just been confused, or just have made wrong in 2-3 places, but you can just replay the video to know about this, and I apologize for that. If this video is helpful to you, then please like, and for more videos tap the subscribe button. And I'll tell you that you can comment on the YouTube channel for more videos in the topic in for which you want the videos. And you can send me the feedbacks how my videos are running so that I can improve my videos. Stay tuned and connected with Akash Biology. Thank you.